At last week's American Society of Clinical Oncology meeting in Chicago, which is by far the largest cancer meeting in the world, probably the most exciting talk was a talk about a drug called T-DM1, which is a drug that will be used for breast cancer that overexpresses a gene called the HER2-new gene. The HER2-new gene is a growth regulatory gene that all of our normal cells have two copies of. In about 20% of breast cancer patients, those cancer cells may have hundreds or even thousands of copies of that gene, and this is referred to as an overexpression of the HER2-new gene. In the past, this was a particularly aggressive form of breast cancer and had a high risk of metastasis. Probably the most important advance in breast cancer in the last 5 or 10 years has been the development of a drug called Herceptin. Herceptin is a monoclonal antibody directed against the HER2-positive breast cancer cell and has resulted in a vast improvement in the prognosis of HER2-positive breast cancer. One of the more exciting developments have been the development of other anti-HER2 drugs. And at this point in time, that is probably the most exciting part of breast cancer research. A drug called Tykerb was developed many years ago, which is a very good drug in patients who have progressed after utilizing Herceptin. The newest drug is a drug called T-DM1, which is an antibody-drug conjugate, meaning that a drug has been attached to an antibody, and in this case, the antibody is Herceptin, the same drug we've been using all along. And the company that developed T-DM1 found a way to attach a drug called emtansine, which is an older, actually fairly toxic drug that was discarded back in the 70s. And they have found a way to attach this drug, or molecules of this drug, to the antibody Herceptin. The way this works is that the Herceptin, as it does as a single agent, finds the HER2-positive breast cancer cell, attaches to it, and takes the emtansine chemotherapy molecule intracellularly and thereby kills the HER2-positive breast cancer cell. The trial presented at ASCO last week, Amelia trial, was a trial of metastatic breast cancer, patients that were HER2 positive that had actually progressed on a taxol or a taxane plus the drug Herceptin. There were about 1,000 patients that were randomized to either receive the more standard approach, which would be Tykerb, the second-line anti-HER2 drug, plus a drug called Zolota, which is a pill, and they compared that to the single-agent T-DM1, which is Herceptin plus this chemotherapy molecule. What they found was in this pretreated group with metastatic breast cancer that had already had Herceptin, that the T-DM1 worked much better than the Tykerb plus Zolota, which was heretofore the best treatment for Herceptin refractory patients. In this pretreated group, the progression-free survival was extended by at least 3 months, and it would appear with further follow-up that the overall survival will be improved compared to the Tykerb plus Zolota. The other exciting part is that T-DM1 has very little toxicity. No hair loss, no nausea and vomiting, and the most common toxicity they saw was a clinically insignificant decrease in the platelet count. So that the hope is that this T-DM1 will be moved probably in the front line of metastatic disease and then ultimately replace Herceptin in the adjuvant setting. This is a very exciting development. This is a drug that has very little toxicity, and if it's better than Herceptin, would be a huge advance in the treatment of HER2-positive breast cancer.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.